trials that we face in 2020 will certainly continue to challenge every one of us in 2021. And getting the answers you need is what 13 Action News is fighting for. And 13 Chief Investigator Darcy Spears focused much of her efforts this year on the crisis with unemployment payments.
The pandemic hit Nevada's economy hard and fast as major conventions canceled one after the other. And that was before stay-at-home orders were put in place. When non-essential businesses were closed, Nevada's unemployment soon became the highest in the country. To make matters worse, our unemployment system was overwhelmed. We started demanding answers. By July, many who needed the lifeline of unemployment insurance the most had gone months without a dime. Here's a look back at the investigations we reported about Dieter and Pua.
Avoidable delays, available fixes, experts waiting in the wings to help, but never called upon.
They missed a lot of opportunity out the gate, and that's very unfortunate.
Former insider Steve Zelke says had leaders in Nevada's unemployment office taken control of this crisis, things would be much better. Instead,
it is imploding on itself.
And people who were approved for payment months ago are still fighting system glitches, jammed phone lines, and inaction. Here's what Zelke expected of the agency he retired from after 25 years.
In the face of the humanity, in face of tens of thousands of people that are losing everything because of system inefficiencies and lack of steady leadership, that someone would come in and say, we need to pull out all the stops.
Apparently, that didn't happen, so this did. A class action lawsuit filed in Washoe County against the state's unemployment division, its directors and administrators.
Broken and sad.
That's how former Dieter adjudicator Laura Fair describes Nevada's unemployment system. Those who count on it know just what she means.
I think it's disgusting that, like, taxpayers, you know, people who are the backbone of, you know, the economy, have to go through those great lengths just to receive what is allotted to them.
And I just want some transparency and accountability.
Don't count on either one, says Fair.
It's just corrupted.
She retired from Nevada's Department of Employment Training and Rehabilitation in 2019 after 10 years as an adjudicator.
After working for unemployment for so many years, I always said, if it's logical or reasonable, unemployment is not going to do it. And it's unfortunate, but it's true.
She says the current situation with pandemic unemployment assistance, or PUA, is evidence of that.
And it's even worse than the regular unemployment system. It's completely messed up. Some of the information that they ask for does not apply to self-employed or gig workers. And it's extremely difficult to get through it.
Tens of thousands of self-employed and gig workers have been waiting months with no money, even after being found eligible for benefits.
We need to pay people or tell them why they're not eligible and give them the right to appeal to an independent third party.
A pretty simple concept coming from new Dieter Strike Force leader Barbara Buckley. But until now, thousands of unemployed workers have heard mostly excuses and the nonstop plea to be patient. Buckley steps into her new position well aware of all that.
People who are desperate, facing eviction, foreclosure, there is a huge problem, and when I was asked, I said yes, because I thought maybe I can make it better for all those who are waiting.
Buckley's paying job is Executive Director of Legal Aid Services of Southern Nevada. She's heading up Dieter's new Rapid Response Strike Force as a volunteer with a purpose.
I'm not going to do much looking in the rearview mirror. I'm going to be looking with laser focus of how to get people paid.
The state's backlog of unpaid unemployment claims has been mired in unprecedented volume and not enough staff, a situation that keeps dragging on.
Why do you think it took 5 months to take a new approach and bring someone like you in?
I don't know. I think that, you know, along the way they were hopeful, right? Hopeful that Alorica would work. Hopeful that the interim, you know, directors would work.
They were wrong, repeatedly.
Hi everyone, my name is David Day. I live in Las Vegas, Nevada, and I am a freelance makeup artist.
David Day created this YouTube video to illustrate how so many claimants get caught between PUA and regular unemployment.
So I spoke with someone on May 17th from PUA who told me, even though I know that you're going to be eligible for PUA because you're self-employed and a gig worker, you still have to go through UI and be denied first.
A model of inefficiency. Dieter's unemployment system remains an expensive head-scratcher for claimants like David Day. He has multiple letters confirming eligibility, but still no money. Why? From Dieter officials to a district court judge to the governor, we keep hearing the same thing.
We know that the state is dealing with an antiquated computer system.
It's one of the primary things they blame for delays in processing claims and getting people paid. But Steve Zelke, a former Dieter manager who was with the agency for over 25 years, says otherwise.
I think there's been some excuses that have been made, some circumstances that have been, for lack of a better term, played out.
In court records filed as part of a class action gig worker lawsuit over unpaid PUA claims, Zelke says the system is not archaic, calling it one of the more modern systems nationwide. In fact, Dieter's computer system went through a $40 million upgrade less than 5 years ago, but former Dieter adjudicator Laura Fair says it didn't help much.
So what did we get for that $40 million?
We got a terrible system.
Alorica's contract wasn't set to expire until the end of the year when the PUA program expires, but the state is pulling out nearly 2 months early so Dieter can operate the call center itself.
We can't have calls to a call center person who doesn't have the ability to fix a claim. That's a waste of time. That's a waste of resources.
Former Assembly Speaker Barbara Buckley spotted flaws in the system from the moment she took over Dieter's new rapid response strike force.
If we're depending on Alorica and Alorica can't do the job, we need somebody who can do the job.
The judge found Dieter in contempt in part of the court's order to pay PUA claimants. It applies to 9,000 people meeting specific requirements and caught in limbo between PUA and regular unemployment. Those are the people who must be paid by December 24th.
The frustration of claimants waiting months for money was echoed by Judge Barry Breslow as Dieter's parade of witnesses offered explanations for failing to abide by his July order.
The court didn't order payments to begin. The court didn't order payments to be made to people who were fraudulently attempting to obtain benefits. The court didn't order the department to blanket pay anybody. That was not the court's order. And the court, frankly, would just remind both sides here that the court narrowly tailored its order to a couple different buckets of people that the court found federal law required payments to be made.
The people the court ordered to be paid are claimants like Heather Boyd, Steve Kolznick, and George Doherty, PUA claimants who Dieter started paying, then stopped. The judge demanded to know who at Dieter ordered PUA payments to stop to people like the claimants who testified. All he got were generalizations. Lead PUA analyst Patricia Allender said there was no willful violation of the court's order, but admitted Dieter could have done a better job helping claimants.
We're continuing to fight for those who are not getting paid. Although many of the people we profiled did get their money, our investigation is ongoing and is also about protecting the overall economy.